Thank you. Trimurti, Shiva, Father, Father Shiva. Today, Trimurti, Father Shiva, has come to meet his very lovely, very sweet Saligram children. Today is the special day for Shiva and the Saligrams. The father is happy to meet his children. As the father has come to celebrate the birthday of his children, and the children say that they have come to celebrate the birthday of the father. So the father is happy and the children are also happy. Why? Because this birthday is the most unique one in the whole Kalpa, the most unique and the most lovely one in the whole Kalpa. Throughout the Kalpa, no one else's birthday has been celebrated in this way. to have a birthday of the father and the children be celebrated together at the same time. Such a type of birthday is never ever celebrated of anyone at any time before. Therefore, Bhak Dada congratulates his children multi-million times. Greetings from the children have been received by Bap Dada right from Amrit Vela. The children have greeted the father. From their hearts, and the children's greetings have reached the father already. On seeing so many children, the Saligrams, Bap Dada sings the song from his heart. Wah, my long lost now found children. Wah, how great are my lovely children, how great. How great are the children who are celebrating the divine Alaukik birthday. Bap Dada is singing the song of Wah Wah for each child. Because out of the millions of souls of the world. You are so few. Children, who are multi-million times fortunate. You have become multi-million times fortunate, and in the future also you will remain fortunate. And I can see the children waving at Baba in response to Baba's words. Baba says, for half a kalpa, you will remain very, very fortunate. This blessing is not for only one birth. For many birds, you have become blessed. You have become blessed for many births. Do all of you have the awareness of this self-respect in you? The Father gives you unlimited inheritance in the form of your birthright on your alaukik birthday. At the time of your very birth, the elevated tilak, the tilak of elevated consciousness is given to you children by the Father at the time of your very birth itself. Tilak. The tilak is on your forehead, is it not? It's already there, isn't it there?
Brahman. Jivan hai.
As when you in your Brahmin life, your tilak is imperishable. That is, as you are a Brahmin, the tilak is imperishable on your forehead. A tilak on a Brahmin's forehead is a sign of elevated fortune. All of you children, even though you are far away in physical distance, are celebrating this birthday, this unique divine birthday with great zeal and enthusiasm. Aren't all of you celebrating? Baba is remembering the children in distant places and saying this. All of you are celebrating, aren't you? Aren't you happy to celebrate? Aren't you happy to see that how Baba is celebrating your birthday and you are celebrating Baba's birthday? Baba is celebrating your birthday and you are celebrating Baba's birthday. How happy are you? How much happy Baba is able to... does Baba hear the feelings of happiness in you? Is there a measurement of your happiness? Is there a measurement of the happiness in you? Could it be measured how happy you are? In this world, there is no measurement of the happiness in you. There is no equipment which can measure the amount of happiness in you. No such equipment has been invented up to now which can measure your happiness. If you were asked that is your happiness as deep as the ocean, what will you say? You'll say that even the ocean is not deep enough to measure your happiness. Okay, is it as high as the sky? And you will say that even that is not the proper measure. It's much more than the height of the sky. That much is the happiness in you, because your home is far beyond the sky. Even the subtle regions is beyond the sky. So nothing of this world can give the measure of the happiness in you. Do you have that much happiness? Do you? Yes, and the children raise their hand and wave at Baba. Yes, Baba likes this one hand clap. And some think when they hear the word clap, they think of clapping with two hands again. So, but most of them have only waved at Baba, and Baba said, yes, all of you have the happiness. Very good. All of you raised your hand when you were told, asked whether you have happiness in that. Congratulations, congratulations. But now the next question. You have understood. You have understood now what question Baba is going to ask. This is why you are laughing. Bap Dada wishes to see each child as a blossomed spiritual flower, not half bloomed but fully blossomed flower, always and fully blossomed. How lovely a fully blossomed flower looks. You enjoy looking at a fully blossomed flower, don't you? And if it has withered a little bit, then what do you do? You keep it away. Bap Dada does not keep you away, but such souls, by themselves, they keep them away. They keep themselves away. And now Baba is giving a very loving drishti to the children, because Baba does not like that children keep themselves away from Baba. So he is giving powerful drishti with blessings that may Baba's children always be with Baba, never be separated from Baba. And Baba continues to give the powerful drishti to give strength to the souls so that they're always with Baba. And Baba continues Today is the day of celebration, is it not? You keep listening to the Murli all the time. Today, you can sing, dance in your mind, in your heart, not with your feet, but in your mind, in your heart. If you start dancing with your feet, there'll be great chaos here. But Bab Dada is seeing that how you children are dancing, and are singing Baba's praise in very sweet, loving words. And also singing the songs of your praise. Baba is able to hear the voice of your mind. The sound is coming from all the countries too. Baba is able to hear them. They are able to hear Baba's voice, and Baba is able to hear their voice. Baba says, oh my lovely, lovely children of the whole world, dance and sing as much as you want. What other work you Brahmins have? What is doing yoga? Is there labor in doing yoga? The meaning of yoga is Atma or Paramatma ka Milan. The meeting of the souls and the Supreme Soul. What happens when there's a meeting? People dance in joy, is it not, when they meet each other? So when you meet Baba in yoga, your heart sings the sweet praise of Baba automatically. This is the task of the Brahmins, to keep singing and dancing. Is it difficult to sing and dance? Is it difficult to sing and dance? No. Is it not? Anyone finds it difficult to sing and dance? Raise your hand. Nowadays, now it is a season of singing and dancing. So So what else have you to do to
nacho.
Sing, a dance?
Gao.
Sing. Nacho is dance. Gao is sing.
Sejena.
It's easy, is it not?
Seje.
Is it easy?
Canto ilao.
At least nod. Or, yes, they raise their hand, they wave at Baba. Yes, Baba, it is easy to sing and dance, they say. It's not difficult, is it? But then, why do you purposely make the difficult things, the easy things difficult? Actually, it is not difficult. It is very easy because the father knows that for half a kalpa you have spent your lives in great difficulty. This is why at this time, everything is made easy for you. Is there anyone who still thinks it is difficult? Those sitting at the back, say, do you find it difficult? Do you find it difficult sometimes? Just as
Rasta bolkar,
if someone whilst moving along forgets his path and takes another path, then he may find it difficult. Similarly, the path of knowledge is not difficult. Brahmin life is not difficult. But instead of being a Brahmin, you become a Kshatriya, means a warrior. Instead of a Brahmin, you become a warrior, Kshatriya. Then the task of a warrior is to fight, to battle. Well, that's always difficult, is it not? To fight, to struggle, to battle. It's always difficult to battle. But to rejoice, that is easy.
The double foreigners.
Now, are the double foreigners the ones who are always rejoicing, experiencing pleasure? Wave your hand to Baba if you are. Only one hand, please, Baba says. Not two hands. You're always rejoicing. Hope you won't go back and say, yeah, no, Baba, I'm confused now, will you? See? Today's day is very important as there's a significance of two things. One is on this day people keep a fast
foreigners kuto manana paraire.
Double foreigners did not have to have any, you know, did not have to keep any fast. In Bharat, they keep fast on this day of Shiv Jayanti. Therefore, one thing which people do on this day is keep a fast. And the second thing is they stay awake whole night. They keep a fast whole day and stay awake whole night. Now, have you also made a fast or held a fast? Because it is pun on the word fast. Fast means to keep a fast, and also vrat means to make a promise or to take a pledge. So you too have taken a pledge, haven't you? Your pledge is, or promise is in a form of a determined thought, is it not? It's a very strong, determined, powerful promise. It's not a weak one. What promise have you? What is the first promise Bap Dada wants you to make? The moment you were applied the tilak of awareness, the first promise you made to Baba was, what was it? What was the first promise you made to Baba when Baba applied the tilak of elevated awareness on your forehead? Baba blessed you, may you be completely pure and as Baba blessed you with these words, you immediately imbibed them and made a promise to Baba that you would lead a pure life. Therefore, the first promise is purity in life. But purity does not merely mean celibacy. But purity means becoming like Brahma Father. Because Baba is rhyming words, punning words. Brahmacharya is celibacy, but Brahmacharya also means becoming like Brahma, adopting the qualities of Brahma. That is purity in thoughts, words and actions. This is called complete Brahmacharya or complete purity, or to adopt the qualities of Brahma, Brahmachari. Purity in thoughts and purity in words means whatever you speak should spread vibrations of purity too. In every thought, vibrations of purity should spread. In every word, vibrations of purity should spread. That is, purity is the most important thing. And in actions, there should be a balance of karma and yoga. That is, to experience oneself as a yogi in action. This is called Brahmachari, that is the one who acts according to his father, according to the father Brahma. You saw in Brahma Baba, didn't you? Every word he spoke was a version. The words were not ordinary words spoken by Brahma Baba, but they were divine versions. And you say, don't you, that your life is not an ordinary life, it is an alaukik, divine life. The word divinity or divine means purity. Therefore, check. Every night, become your own teacher and check yourself. And then, according to the amount of percentage of purity in you, give marks to yourself.
100%.
You have to become 100%. However, for that you have to check yourself every day. Don't check anyone else. Bab Dada has seen that instead of checking yourself, you check others, because that is very easy to check others. But you have to see to yourself that on this day or today, whether in my thoughts, my words, and my actions, how much purity there was in my thoughts, in my words, in my actions. How much percentage of purity there was. What message have you given to everyone this year? You have given this message in all the functions or celebrations or festivals you have held, wherever you have given lectures, you have spoken on the subject of transformation. You have given very good speeches on this subject of transformation. You have given the aim of transformation even to others in your speeches. Because when you celebrated the different festivals everywhere, you did give this message. Bab Dada is very happy to know. Now, you have to give this message to yourself too. That is, you have to check within yourself whether I am experiencing transformation every day or not. You have to check to what extent, that is, how much percentage of transformation has come in you. Is the transformation, is the percentage of transformation becoming higher and higher? The percentage should be higher, not lower. There should be a rise in the percentage, not a decline. Bab Dada keeps looking at the chart of every child. You may be wondering, can Baba see everyone's chart? Each child's chart Baba checks, or does he check only of some special souls? No, Baba. Checks the charts of everyone. Even if he is last or he is fast, but Baba checks everyone's chart. It's not that he checks every day, he does it sometimes. Sometimes he checks everyone's chart. You're smiling. Do you want Baba to tell your chart? Tell about your chart? No, Baba is not going to say, because today is a day to celebrate, is it not? You know? Baba thinks of a serious point and then he stops himself and says, no, today you have come to celebrate. Then Baba smiles. However, but, however, Baba is signaling you for the future. Baba is signaling you for the future. As the significance of today is to make a determined thought. now.
Such a bogat.
The true bhagats never break their fast. If they keep a fast, they never break it. So here, keeping a fast means making a promise. Therefore, Baba says, the day of today has the significance of keeping a fast or making a promise, and real good bhagats never break their fast. So Baba is again signaling you that from now onwards, you have to make yourself strong, because up to now, as Baba can see, that the foundation in the form of thought power is not that strong, because a lot of power, thought energy is being wasted in the form of wasteful thoughts. The amount of thought energy which should be used for the self and for the world is not being used to that much extent. You have to increase this energy much more. Because only on the basis of thought energy your words are spoken and your actions are done. Therefore, transform your thought energy and transform your thought energy, which is now going into waste or is negative, into powerful energy for transformation of self and the world. Bhaktada says that the treasure of thought energy is the greatest treasure. Isliye. This is why become the incarnation of economy of thought energy. That is, do not waste your thoughts, economize this energy. Today is the day of incarnation, is it not? Bab Dada has great hope in the children, and Baba wishes that as it is the day of incarnation, let you also be the incarnations of economy. That is, you have to economize your thoughts. Don't waste your thought energy. Don't allow negativity to come in your thoughts. So save the thought energy. Baba is rhyming words, punning words. Economize your thoughts. Save your thoughts. And once you are able to save your thoughts, all other treasures will automatically be saved. Once you are able to save the treasure of thoughts, other treasures will automatically be saved. So what are you going to become in the year 99? 99 year has already started. First you were thinking that what will happen in the year 1999? Okay, let anything happen in the world. What does it matter to you? You are not going to be harmed in any way, so let anything happen in 99. Are you frightened? Are you afraid? And you're thinking what will happen? Because usually there's a fear only when you're not aware of what is going to happen. Yes, children, whatever will happen will be good. For you, it will definitely be good. For the world, let anything happen. But you have to become fearless. And remain cheerful. And observe the game, the play. You have to remain fearless, cheerful, and just observe the game. Usually in a play, they not only show murder, but they also show romance, love. Baba saying love. So there is love, there is fighting, there is suspense. They show good things, they show bad things. Everything in a game, in a play. But then, is anyone afraid of watching a play? Do they say, oh, what'll happen now? What'll happen now? Do they think in this way? They just enjoy the play, don't they? So this too is also an unlimited play. If you have the slightest fear, or you're slightly confused and you say, oh, what's happened? What is happening? This should not be happening. Why did it happen? Then the one with such a stage of fright and confusion will be definitely affected. If one is not stable in his stage, then he will definitely be confused and frightened. Therefore, let it be the year 1999 or let it be the year 2000. Why are you afraid? Why are you concerned? Let anything come. Just enjoy everything, watch everything with pleasure. Don't be afraid. Don't say, hey, what has happened? Let not even such a thought come in your mind. Many ask, what will happen in 99? Will something happen or will nothing happen in 99? Now Bab Dada says, actually, it is you people who have given nature some service. You know, just like you give your servant a service of sweeping, you give him a long, long broom stick to sweep. So nature will do its job. That's its service. Why are you afraid? It is actually going to do the job of sweeping because you have ordered it to sweep. Why are you afraid then? You ordered it to sweep, didn't you? You have to remain unshakable, stable, and make your mind and intellect very powerful. You are to make your stage very strong, unshakable, immovable, stable, and just watch the game of nature. You should not be frightened. as you are alaukik beings. You are not ordinary beings. Alaukik means elevated, heavenly, divine beings. You're not ordinary beings. Ordinary beings will be confused and go through upheavals, but alaukik beings are Master Almighty Authority Souls. They will only watch everything as a game, as a play, and keep themselves busy in the task of world benefit. If you keep your mind and intellect free, then you will surely be frightened. But if you keep your mind and intellect like a lighthouse and keep spreading light all around and make yourself busy in this task, then a busy soul is never frightened. It becomes an observer. Even if there is a disturbance, you have to keep your intellect very, very clear. Never keep your intellect empty, but let it be filled with Baba's remembrance. That is, keep yourself busy with Baba and me. It may be that letters won't reach, your telephone will not work, teleprinter, fax and emails, all these different methods of communication may not work, but still, if your thoughts are clear, then you will get the vibrations very easily and clearly, because these equipments of science can deceive you anytime. Never make them your support. Yes, you may use them, but don't allow these gadgets to become your support. Don't make your life be based on these gadgets. These equipments of science, a means of science, in spite of them being there, you will not be able to use them. In spite of they being there, therefore, the means of silence will work everywhere, wherever you are, in whatever situation you may be. But the means of silence will work, and will work and be useful to you easily and quickly and work accurately. But for that, you have to keep the line of your intellect very clear. Did you understand? Now, actually, you are invoking golden age, aren't you? Aren't you saying that golden age should come quickly, jaldi jaldi? So, for golden age to come, you have to make this world clean. So nature will do the job of sweeping and swabbing for making this world clean. Nature will do the job. Therefore, on this day, make a determined thought. Let it not be only a thought, but it should be a determined thought. What are you going to determine in you today? I must become an incarnation of economy. That is, I must economize my thoughts, my words, my actions, and save my mental energy. So, you have to economize in everything. The next thing is keep your intellect clear. Which, in other words, Bap Dada says, the Master, the Lord, is pleased with an honest heart. A true heart, an honest heart. Clean heart.
Vartaman samay mein.
That is needed. The need of the hour is cleanliness and truthfulness in the heart. Let the heart be clean, honest, and let there be honesty with the family and honest with Baba. So honest with the self, honest with the family, honest with Baba. Did you understand? Baba didn't want to say all this today, but still he said it. Remember, Baba was saying, today you have come to celebrate, but still Baba could not keep it. He said it. Baba loves you, doesn't he? Baba loves you. And therefore, he cannot bear seeing even the slightest of weakness in you. Bap Dada wishes to see every child perfect as he is. And Baba continues again to give Drishti. Baba is giving Sakash to children, power to children, so that children become like him. It's another powerful Drishti Baba is giving to all the children in the hall, and also to all his children who are in different corners of the world, remembering Baba at this time. countries are here.
Sick unto me.
And Papa continues.
Jarlath.
In 1 second. You should be able to be detached, because nature can create upheaval in all four directions. All the five elements of nature, supposing they are creating upheaval, Baba is now telling us to imagine, supposing all the five elements are creating upheaval, but and not a single place is free from that upheaval. There is upheaval in human beings. There is upheaval in nature. Baba wants you to imagine all this. There's upheaval in human beings, upheaval in nature. And at such a time, when there is upheaval everywhere, in every part of the world, what are you going to do then? Supposing there is upheaval everywhere, what are you going to do then? Which is the safest method for you, the method to keep yourself safe, the method of safety, what is it for you?
Seek me.
Within a second. Become bodiless. So become bodiless in a second. That is, become soul conscious. Soul consciousness will make you stable even in the midst of upheavals. But will you be able to become soul conscious in a second, or will it take you time to become soul conscious? Try it now itself. Within a second, stabilize your mind and intellect wherever you want them to be. Can you do it? Can you stabilize your mind and intellect wherever you want them to be in a second? And Baba goes into deep silence again, making the children become detached in a second as Baba is himself, so stable, so detached. Again, a powerful drishti, and there is pin drop silence in the hall. Everyone is still. Baba continues,
sadhana.
This is called sadhana, spiritual endeavor. Okay. To all the souls of this land and other lands in all four corners who are lost in the Father's love, to all the loving, cooperative children who stabilize themselves in the stage of true brahmacharya, that is, they adopt the same acts of Brahma Father. To all the courageous children who economize their thoughts, words and actions, who are stable even in adverse situations of instability, to such fearless souls, who always experience pleasure, to the children who are always close to the father, Bap Dada's love, remembrance, and namaste salutations. And the children wave at Baba, clap with one hand. Baba received the cards of you children. Many, all have sent birthday cards to Baba. And double foreigners have also sent Valentine's Day cards to Baba. 14th February is Valentine's Day, the day of lovers. So Baba says the children have sent the cards of love, Valentine's Day cards to Baba. So along with the greetings of Shivratri, greetings of love to all of you for your cards of love on the day of love. Congratulations, congratulations, congratulations to you. The Murli is over, and now Dadiji is preparing to get up from a seat, and there are many brothers sitting in the front, you know, the photographers, the video cameras are all in the front, and Baba is saying that you have made a very good office, and greetings to all of you who are sitting here with video cameras and other cameras and the big machines and all that. So greetings to all of you, to the Madhuban Nivasis who are sitting here with their equipments. Also those who are working with different equipments everywhere, Yad Pia to them, because you know wireless is also working from here straight to Madhuban, Gyan Sarovar, as well as Sangam Bhavan, everywhere, even Ahmedabad.
किसे आप मस्ती से अपना जन्म अरे ना चुगाओ मस्ती में अपना जन्मदिन मनाओ मस्ती से अपना जन्मदिन मनाओ एक साथ बाप और बच्चों का ये आया जन्मदिन बाबा मुबारक आपको ये प्यारा जन्मदिन एक साथ बाप और बच्चों का ये आया जन्मदिन प्यारे बाबा मुबारक आपको ये प्यारा जन्मदिन खुशियां मनाओ अरे नाचो गाओ खुशियां मनाओ अरे नाचो गाओ मस्ती से अपना जन्मदिन मनाओ मस्ती से अपना जन्मदिन है देश विदेश शिव बाबा आए भारत में देना है संदेश तिरसठवीं जयंती मनाते खुश है देश विदेश शिव बाबा आए भारत में देना है संदेश
Everyone is happy on this day as we celebrate Shiv Baba's birthday. This is the birthday of the one who is beyond birth. We are celebrating the birthday of the one who is beyond birth. What a unique birthday it is. It is a birthday of the father and the children. Shiv Baba comes and brings along with him Brahma Baba and the Brahmin children. The sky has changed, the earth has changed, the whole life has changed. Diwali has come back, there is light everywhere. Greetings to you, Baba, on your birthday. It is a birthday of the father and the children. The heart is flying high in the heart as well as in the world. Shiv Baba's flag will be hoisted by Shiv Baba himself. We have seen God Himself celebrating His birthday.
Shiva's flag is high and elevated.
Fell all over on everyone, showered blessings. Everyone is waving at Baba. Baba himself is waving at everyone. And now Baba is going to speak. I hope everyone has FM radio, those who are on the stage. There won't be any translation from our side. Baba continues to speak. Today, is the birthday of the father and the children, and greetings to you for the birthday of both. Just as at this time all of you are rejoicing so much, so too may this remain immortal, may this remain always. Just as this flag was hoisted and petals of roses fell, they were showered. Similarly, in your hearts too, let the flag of Baba's remembrance fly high. Never allow, never let the flag of Baba's remembrance to fall down. Then the world will say, oh fortunate souls, oh fortunate souls, how blessed you are with their good wishes and blessings. All of you will be showered on one hand, let the flag of Baba's remembrance fly high in your heart, and on the other hand, the message of the Father which you received today, that you have to become an incarnation of economy. So let the flag of determined thought that I have to be an incarnation of economy fly high in your heart also, along with that. Let the flag of Shiv Baba be made to fly high in front of the world. This is the service you have to do now. This is the importance of the flag. A day will come, it's not far away, it will come very soon, when everyone will sing the praise of the Father and stand under Shiv Baba's flag and take the support of this flag. And you, the children of the supporter, of the support of the world, will become the canopy of protection for the whole world. Okay. To all the children in all four corners of the world, whether they are in towns or small countryside places, to all the children, especially to those children who are in very, very remote corners, to them special Yad Pyar, and also to you, Yad Pyar. How many times, how much congratulations should be given to you? However much is given is always not enough. Many more times greetings to you than what you can really accumulate inside you. So Baba bless the children, that let the flag of Baba fly high in your hearts, and let it also fly high in the world. In this way, you will glorify the Father. So now, many brothers and sisters are on the stage with candles. And now will be the candle lighting ceremony. There are beautiful candles on different tables on the stage. These candles have come all the way from Malaysia. They are from Malaysia, and the shape of the candles is the form of a lotus flower. So lotus flower candles, beautiful pink colored lotus flower candles with a green base and pink lotus on the top. So each one has been given a candle to light the candles on the tables, as it is 63rd birthday of Shiv Baba. As 63 years ago Shiv Baba came on this earth, and therefore today we are celebrating the 63rd birthday. Baba continues to give drishti to everyone, to bless everyone, Baba's hand is raised, waving and blessing the children, and the children respond by waving their hand. And now Baba goes back, and all the seniors are on the stage. Baba is given a candle, and Baba will light first. Baba lit the candle first, and now everyone else is lighting the candle. The stage looks so beautiful with each one holding a candle in his hand. And some interesting music going on. Each one is clapping. Baba is coming. So Baba continues to stand, and everyone comes in front of Baba to light the many candles which are on the table. They're not just 63 candles, there are many, many more. As I can see, at least over 100 Brahmins on the stage, all with candles, and are lighting them. A very beautiful cake has been made, actually not one, but three cakes have been made, and very big ones. One is milk cake, the other is dry fruit cake, and the third is the normal cake, but very big in size, so that will come next. That will be the second part of the celebration. Even with so many people on the stage, everything is happening very, very peacefully. Posing for a photograph. Brother Ramesh takes a photo of all around Baba. Very interesting photograph with Baba standing and everyone standing behind Baba or near Baba, around Baba. Thank you.
Shanti, all those sisters and brothers who are standing on the stage
is being now.
They will Baba will sit on the gaddi and they will come in line and take drishti from Baba and will go back to their place.
So Baba is sitting down and those Baba will sit on the gaddi are being told
and
to
all
come
those
in a line
and brothers
to take
who are standing
drishti
on
from Baba.
Stage, you will take drishti from Baba in
very interesting toy which she gave to Baba. Foreigners are taking drishti from Baba and going in a line back to their seats after having taken drishti.
sisters and brothers who from different countries are requested to take your seat back. गुजरात की वह बहनें जिन्होंने केक काट लिया वह भी सभी अपने अपने स्थान पर जाके बैठे. तीन लोक दिखाए गए हैं, ब्रह्मापुरी, विष्णुपुरी और सूक्ष्म वतन दिखाया है. तीन लोक का दिखाया गया है, केक के रूप में बनाया गया है. बाबा सदा हमें तीन लोक भाई बहने टोली बांटना शुरू करें. भाई बहने सभी को जो बैठे हुए हैं हॉल में उन सबको टोली बांटना शुरू करें और सभी भाई बहने टोली बैठे बैठे लेंगे. कोई भी टोली लेने के लिए
say to the internet, that media, that we are starting this new media program. He's going to, the Baba is going to inaugurate it.
Who
said? Gangaram Bhai told me. But now it's over, no? He came very late.
Thank you.
So now Brother Karuna and Brother Gangaram and Mr. Kamal Dixit, they've come and they're going to start a new newspaper, a monthly newspaper by the BKs, by the Brahma Kumaris, for world service, a new newspaper starting from today, and Baba's inaugurating it. It's like a little magazine for outsiders. Brother Kamal Dixit will be the main editor. He is actually a journalist and professor of journalism in some journalism college. He is Baba's child, and Baba is giving him a bouquet. गोलो खुश हो गया टोली ले आओ ना हम लोगों के लिए
मिला नहीं टोली
नहीं कहाँ कैबिन में तुम्हें कहाँ दिया है ले आओ ले आओ
नहीं करें। सभी भाई बहने बैठ जाएं। बाबा आप सबको देख रहे हैं और जब तक बाबा हमारे संग है तब तक हम बाबा के साथ का अनुभव करेंगे। सब शांति से बैठ जाएं, कोई आवाज नहीं करें। कोई भी भाई बहने आवाज नहीं करे, बाबा बात कर रहे हैं। जिनसे बाबा बात कर रहे हैं उन्हें बात सुनने दीजिए। सब बैठ जाएं, सभी भाई बहने शांति से बैठे, कोई भी आवाज नहीं करे। शांति। जो भी भाई बहने सीढ़ी के पास खड़े हैं, उनसे निवेदन है कि वो बैठ जाएं। बाद में आप सबको मिलाया जाएगा, कोई भी अभी ऊपर नहीं आएंगे। बाबा को अभी भोजन, बाबा को अभी फ्रूट स्वीकार करा रहे हैं।
Thank you.
कहाँ मिलेगा बाबा ऐसा सतयुग में तेरा प्यार हो, सतयुग में तेरा प्यार। भले ही रों के महल में होंगे, भले ही रों के महल में होंगे, सुख के अति भर मार हो, कहाँ मिलेगा तेरा प्यार बाबा, कहाँ मिलेगा तेरा प्यार बाबा, कहाँ मिलेगा।
अपने मन की बात तुम्हें मन मंदिर के मूरत बाबा रख लो दिल के साथ तुम्हें मन मंदिर के मूरत बाबा रख लो दिल के साथ तुम्हें
लिया।
हसीन बाबा तुम सा हसीन बाबा कोई नहीं जहां में कोई नहीं जहां में तुमने हसीन
तब तक बैठे रहेंगे जब तक गुलजार दादी जी वापस आए। कल प्रातः 5:30 बजे अमृत वेला होगा और 6:30 से 7 योग, 7 बजे मुरली क्लास होगी और डबल विदेशी भाई बहने ध्यान दें जो ज्ञान सरोवर में ठहरे हैं। कल टुमारो 5:30 अमृत वेला, 7:00 मुरली एंड आफ्टर दैट 10:00 All the double foreigners will go to Pandav Bhavan for flag hoisting ceremony. और कल 11 बजे पांडव भवन में झंडारोहण का कार्यक्रम होगा। शांति वन में प्रातः क्लास के बाद यहाँ पर होगा, जैसा कि पहले बताया जा चुका है। पांडव भवन में 11 बजे झंडारोहण का कार्यक्रम होगा और ज्ञान सरोवर में जो भी विदेशी भाई बहने हैं वह 10:30 के अंदर ओम शांति भवन में पहुँचेंगे। पहले हॉल में बैठेंगे और 11 बजे पांडव भवन में झंडारोहण का कार्यक्रम होगा।